Neil, you had a presentation here at the meat show about swine genetics. What was it all about?
Basically, it was about how we're changing selection, moving into genomic selection in order to increase the accuracy of selection. We're able to make more progress in improving traits like feed conversion, robustness of the animals, in order to deliver a product that's using less inputs, less feed, reduce the waste that the pigs have, and to just to make a more sustainable product for the future.
It's all about creating more value from the material today.
Yes, it's about creating value, reducing costs. There's a big focus on increasing the weights of pigs. We see that all around the world where packers are wanting to increase the weights. It's important for us to try to select animals at those higher weights so we're getting exactly what our end customer wants, is moving to a heavier pig that's more efficient and meets all of their needs from a meat perspective.
You mentioned sustainability, and that's a really hot topic in the food industry.
It is, it is. You know, even within the U.S., there's quite a few consortiums put together where they're looking at the sustainability of ag-related businesses. A lot of the large major packing plants, whether in the pork industry, beef industry, or poultry industry, they're directly involved with that. You know, it's definitely a hot topic, and definitely most companies of any size, they're involved with it and trying to make sure that their production is sustainable. If it's not sustainable, they're not making a profit. So in order to be profitable, you've got to be sustainable.
If you look at the how Marel is presenting their equipment and solutions, automation seems to be where the meat industry is heading.
Very much so. You see more and more. I see plants all over the world, and you see more in automation each day. I'm always excited to see the new automation, and it just takes some of the variability out that you see in the product. And if you remove the variability, you're going to have a better end product that will be acceptable to the consumer.
Any final thoughts for the future in this industry?
The big thing is, you know, how do we move forward on heavy weights? We've got to get the equipment right in the plants, learn to cut a different, larger product to where it fits the consumer's need. And I think that's where we're going to go, and we got to focus on the equipment to be able to do those things.